r/AskReddit. What myth is still widely circulated as truth? Organic crops don't use pesticides or herbicides. Another myth is that organic farming is somehow always better for the environment. In many cases, it can actually be much worse. One example is that in conventionally grown crops, you can use precisely calibrated fertilizer so that you're feeding your crops exactly as much nitrogen as they need through the soil. Whereas with some types of organic fertilizers, you have to way overshoot it to make sure the soil is fertilized sufficiently, which results in massive nitrogen runoff and water pollution. Edit. Oh my god. Guys, I said that the myth is that organic farming is always better for the environment, and that the absolute statement simply isn't true. With this one example of some types of fertilizer, I don't know how so many people got out of that comment that I'm saying all organic farming is terrible for the environment. I quite enjoyed the comments accusing me of being an astroturfer / shill for Monsanto. The ugly truth is that while there are many organic and conventional farmers who care deeply about the environment and study agricultural science to do what's best for their farms and embrace sustainable practices, there are also many farmers, especially massive agro-business operations, who will do the bare minimum to get the certified organic checkmark and don't really care about sustainability or anything beyond quarterly profits. My point was that people see the organic label and make a lot of assumptions about what that label necessarily denotes in line with their own value system. And those assumptions are often not accurate. In some cases, following the letter of the certification requirements without much additional thought can lead to worse environmental outcomes than in conventional farming. As demonstrated in this research meta-analysis, organic farming can be environmentally friendly and sustainable. Organic farming is not necessarily environmentally friendly and sustainable. Knuckle cracking doesn't lead to arthritis. It's just an old wives' tale people use in place of simply telling you it's annoying them. Crack away. All this time I could have been playing my Game Boy. This is why I had a crappy little light that plugged into my Game Boy and let me almost see a small part of the screen if I really squinted. It was shaped like an Ekans though, so it was cool. That Marilyn Manson removed two of his ribs to blow himself. So you're telling me I didn't have to remove two of my ribs to be able to blow Marilyn Manson? You didn't have to, but I appreciate you going the extra mile. I will never understand how this one traveled around the world before widespread use of the internet for stuff like this. Some of the other ones, sure, there were stuff that sounded medical or scientific, were circulated by papers or magazines. But this one somehow circulated in places that may have never even known who Marilyn Manson was. Gum takes 7 years to digest. No, that's if you eat people. People take 7 years to digest. No, gum takes 7 people to digest. Scientists don't know how bees fly. According to all known laws of aviation, you, with the physics, get out of here. It's a mystery. Bulls hate red. They are actually colorblind and are reacting to the movement of the cloth and the a-hole behind it. You also gotta keep in mind those bulls are poorly treated and usually given some kind of stimulants. Bulls on our ranch are actually quite friendly as long as it's not breeding season. Can confirm. I once had a bull knock me over and stand above me because he wanted chest scratches. He was a big baby that wanted what he wanted, when he wanted it. Edit. Did not expect this to blow up. I am at work and can't do detailed responses or additional stories at this time. Sorry. See below for the tale of Blue, my guard goat. Undercover police have to tell you they are policemen when you ask them. Breaking Bad has a great scene where an undercover cop tricks a guy into selling him drugs using this myth. I thought we were going to hang out. Poor Badger. Catherine the Great died after attempting to have sex with a horse. This myth was started by the French, and then they ask why everyone believes Napoleon was a tiny, tiny man. Napoleon being small was a myth started by the British. He wasn't actually short for his time. If I remember correctly, he was a bit above average in terms of height. I was adamantly told by some seniors at work not to drink the water that boiled twice because it cooks the oxygen out of it. People don't drink water for the oxygen. Even though, if the oxygen was all gone, there would be only hydrogen left, and that makes no sense. So whoever believes that is stupid. Edit. I was joking. I should have mentioned that earlier. I'm sorry for any confusion. that the tongue has different regions for salty, sweet, bitter and sour. Why were we ever taught that? Damn you, Ms. Frizzle. Your blood is blue when not oxygenated. Edit. Thank you all for my first awards. I never thought such a simple answer could have such an impact. Holding B plus down increases your chances of catching a Pokemon. Basically any schoolyard Pokemon rumor. I wasted so many hours scouring the Seafoam Cavern looking for that stupid mist stone. If you beat the Elite Four 13 times in a row without doing anything else in between, a secret door will open up. People believe in the whole Alpha and Beta Wolves thing. It's not true. The leaders of the pack are the parents. In natural wolf packs, the alpha male or female are merely the breeding animals, the parents of the pack, and dominance contests with other wolves are rare, if they exist at all. Yup, the guy who pioneered this theory spent the rest of his life, or is spending the rest of his life, trying to debunk this. The myth. You can tell if a snake is venomous or not by the shape of its pupil. Slit for venomous, round for non-venomous. The truth. Pupil shape has absolutely nothing to do with whether or not a snake has venom. And, if you're close enough to get a good look at a snake's pupils, you're probably close enough to get bit. The advice. If you cannot, from a safe distance, immediately identify a snake beyond a reasonable doubt. Assume it's dangerous and behave accordingly. Keep your distance. Stay out of its direct path. And keep your eyes on it until one or the other of you leaves the area. That shaving makes your beard grow better. When I was a teenager, a lot of people told me that shaving would make my beard grow faster. Well, I didn't want to shave any more than I absolutely had to, so I often went weeks at a time without shaving. It wasn't the best look for me. The idea was that a teenager who'd keep patchy growth on would really want good facial hair. So the whole shave it to make it more prominent was just a clever way for adults to convince teenagers to keep that dirt stash off. A lot of people still believe a woman sued McDonald's because her coffee was hot. In reality, the woman had third-degree burns throughout her pelvic area and only asked that her medical bills be paid. It was like only $30,000 or something and McDonald's went, nope, here is like $200 bucks. So she sued. They were selling illegally hot coffee without a proper warning. Then, McDonald's spread this lie to keep their good name. People in general, though the world was flat until Columbus sailed the ocean blue. No, the ancient world figured that out a long time before. People just thought that it wasn't possible to sail across the ocean to Asia because sailors would run out of food by then. While Columbus thought that wasn't case because he thought Asia was bigger than contemporary estimates. That you can tell if someone is a virgin by looking at their hymen to see if it is intact. OMG, I recently remembered that in middle school and high school, we believed that you could tell someone wasn't a virgin if they had a thigh gap. Woman face palming. That Mr. Rogers was a sniper and or had tattoos covering his arms. Both untrue. Fred Rogers lived a pretty mundane life and dedicated considerable time to creating television programming that didn't rot kids' brains. That whole you eat 7 spiders a year myth. It was created by some lady in the late 90s or early 2000s to prove that ridiculous things can be found on the internet, spread like wildfire, and believed by men. Edit. Wow, this blew up. Thank you to all who clarified that it was Lisa Holt, a troll. Edit 2. Maybe. And the fact that this is older than the internet. Myths are weird. It's actually 7 in a lifetime. If you're on your deathbed and have only swallowed one, the other 6 will swarm your mouth at once. Press lips together, keep the 7th spider out, I am immortal. Urine neutralizes jellyfish stings. Use vinegar instead. That stuff will actually save you. At least long enough for an ambulance to arrive. Can confirm that vinegar helps a lot. Also warm salt water as well. Both helped a lot when I got stung. Who had vinegar at the beach? The lifeguards? The white on blue roundel in the BMW logo represents the white blades of a propeller against the blue sky, alluding to BMW's history as a manufacturer of aircraft engines. This myth was popularized in BMW's advertising for aircraft engines, and perpetuated by the movie Finding Forrester. In truth, the blue and white come from the Bavarian flag, presented as a circular coat of arms in reverse order to avoid a trademark law prohibiting the use of symbols of state sovereignty in a commercial trademark. It was only in later marketing for aircraft engines they overlaid the logo over spinning propellers, as coincidentally it could be taken to look like a propeller against the sky. They made all sorts of engines for land vehicles as well. The Bermuda Triangle. Turns out ships and planes disappear at the same rate all over the world's oceans. The mystery of how the pyramids were built. They know how they were built. Ramps, pulleys, ropes and labor. Carrots being good for your eyes. It was a myth created in World War II by the Allies to explain how their pilots got so good at shooting down enemy planes all of a sudden. The real reason was radar technology. A vitamin A deficiency absolutely causes night blindness. However, eating extra vitamin A won't give you superhuman vision. The belief that vaccines cause autism. I don't even hear that much anymore. It has just evolved into, I'm not taking a vaccine, it's not natural, in a ducking pandemic, no less. Their fear stems from a doctor that made up a bullshit report that wasn't peer-studied, and was paid for by special interest group. He had his medical license revoked. This one hit me personally and drives me absolutely crazy. The singer Ciara is a man. She just popped out her third kid. This is Study Learned circulating. Are you possibly thinking of the singer Lord? I've heard compelling arguments that she's not a New Zealand pop singer, but actually a 45-year-old male geologist from a small town in Colorado. I am Lord. Yep. That washing chicken gets it rid of bacteria. No, cooking chicken gets rid of bacteria. Given that you do it well, washing chicken, on the other hand, can contaminate your whole kitchen with salmonella. The China has never waged a war of aggression propaganda bullshit still lives on in some. Ask the folks of Tibet and Vietnam whether that's true. Shaving hair causes it to grow back longer and thicker. If I remember right, shaved hair looks thicker because the ends are now blunted instead of being tapered. Antibiotics can cure virus infections. No, they don't. That the seeds are the spiciest part of a hot pepper. The seeds are the only part of a pepper that isn't spicy. The white stuff near the seeds though. Spice maximum. That colds are caused by lower temperatures. The cold is a virus that transmits between people. Edit. A lot of people are saying that cold temperatures weaken the immune system and thus indirectly make you more susceptible. And while it's true, the direct cause for common colds are caused by human contact. The internet is a series of tubes. Epstein killed himself. That corsets are a lethal torture item and every Victorian woman did tight lacing. The myth about harmful corsets was started by Victorian men, in order to bring down women-owned businesses. And some feminists, looking at you, Emma Watson swallowed that lie, hook and sinker, thinking they are empowering somebody with it. The truth is, corsets are way better than bras. If you have back pains, which many women have because of their bras, switch to corsets. There is a reason why it was used that long. That you get to adulthood at 18 and you're going to magically know how to be an adult starting at 18. Edit. Wow, this blew up while I was away doing the dishes. Hello my fellow adult children. We will figure this out along the way. I believe in all of us. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.